Here I am. I'm at WhoFest 3, and it's the start of the convention. And guess who I run into? I ran into her. It's Eve Miles from Torchwood.
Hi, how are you? Everything all right? Having a nice time?
I'm having a great time.
I don't even know how I got here.
Maybe in the doctor's... Wait, you haven't gone to the doctor's store, have you?
Yes, I have. I've been in the TARDIS many times.
Oh, well, she got here in the TARDIS then.
Yes, it was lovely to meet you.
And very lovely to meet you as well.
Oh. Enjoy your weekend.
By the way, you probably don't know this, but Torchwood is an anagram of Doctor Who. Okay, here I am again, WhoFest 3 has been fantastic, and I've gotten to meet Clovis Ball from Doctor Who. He has a couple of stories, Revelation of the Daleks and Age of Steel, and it's been fantastic seeing you here, and so have you been enjoying the convention so far?
Absolutely fantastic. My first time in Dallas, and I'm loving it. I love all the conventions, and the only reason we're here is because of the fans, and just thank you fans, you're just amazing.
Thank you very much. It's been fantastic seeing you and talking to you.
And don't forget, the future of the cyber industries.
One of the highlights of being here at WhoFest 3 has been getting to meet Fraser Hines and Wendy Padbury from Doctor Who. It's been fantastic, and fantastic to see you and to talk to you. And so how have you been enjoying the convention so far?
Oh, we've had a brilliant time.
Yeah, great time.
Absolutely
really.
Brilliant
yeah.
time. Yeah. A lot of fun.
And the people are nice.
Yes.
And I just couldn't wait to come to Dallas because it's got a lot of history, obviously. And so we came in early and I went downtown and saw all the JFK place.
Yeah.
And the stuff. We're going to the stockyards tomorrow. So awesome. We always like to get in early and see. Otherwise, you'd see
all you see is a hotel room. So. No, we've had an amazing time.
I'm very glad that you had the time. It's been great seeing you. Hope to see you again very soon. Oh, no. Right. When I say run, run. Run! have Peter Bixie, the master of ceremonies for WhoFest 3, as well as previous WhoFest. And it's been great seeing. I think you've been doing a great job, as usual, being the MC. And so I'm wondering, as a Whovian, what do you think would be like the main thing that has contributed to Doctor Who's popularity at lasting as long as it has so far, not only here in the States, but, you know, internationally?
Well, I have been a fan since 1980-something. 1980, actually, 1970, 1980. And, you know, for a long time, for me, it was just about... There's something that drew me, but I didn't understand what. But as I've gotten older and as I've had the opportunity to travel across fandoms, the one thing I've been able to learn about the Doctor Who fandom, about Doctor Who himself, and about what the show represents, is that the Doctor is the person who stands up against bullies, whether it's the monster under the bed or the monster in the cosmos. But not only does he do that, because, you know, we have people who stand up,
right,
but with his companions, he's teaching others how to do the same. And we've had the show long enough to see the legacy of other people like Sarah Jane Smith and the heroes of Torchwood, who were different before meeting the Doctor and then understood what their role was, which was to not take advantage of what the technology was, but to stand up to the bullies and use technology to do that.
Right. Yeah. And, you know, for me, I think one of the things that it really sets it apart from everything else is the fact that you have this one character played by many, you know, that the character regenerates when necessary. And even though there's a different face, slightly different personality, there's still a common thread that goes all the way from the first Doctor up to the current Doctor. Mm-hmm. To me, that's one of the great things I think about Doctor Who. And it really, I think, personally for me, I think it's one of the things that contributed lasting so long.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I've loved it ever since I started watching when I was in junior high.
Yeah, and that's, you know, I started just before junior high. And but you're right, and that common thread, because there is a common thread, but what is that common thread? Well, let's talk about what it isn't. What we love about each of the Doctors is their uniqueness, the fact that they're different, even if they're irascible or cantankerous, or if they're funny and lovely. You know, we have a connection with all the kookiness, but what is the one thing that connects them all the way through? And what do they have in varying degrees? And that's their humanity. You know, the fact that an alien with the humanity, and that's what we're experiencing, is we are connected through our humanity, but we are separated by our individuality. And the fact that we see this character, the hero of the character, who will one day be a hero who is of no consequence of sex or minority or race. And so we will have a Doctor who will be female, a Doctor who will be black or Asian or what have you, Indian perhaps. And the reason why that's important is because the Doctor of the 60s was an older white man who was leading the world. You know, he was rebelling against it, but he was having to do that himself. And so now the world has changed. And now we've had a chance as a Doctor and the world to grow and to keep that common thread of humanity, but to experience our individuality, to experience love, to experience family, to experience loss. And that's what I think that thing that goes from one through whatever will be the sense of humanity and how we relate to it.
Right. Absolutely. Well said. Thank you very much. I've enjoyed talking with you, and I hope to see you at WhoFest 4 and talk to you again.
I do too. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, here I am on WhoFest 3. It's been incredibly awesome, and I've had the singular pleasure of meeting Winston Churchill himself in the form of Mr. Ian McNeice. And it's been great seeing you here, and how have you liked WhoFest so far?
Oh, it's been fantastic. I mean, we had a great time here over the 3 days here in Dallas, of all places. Nice coming back to Dallas. I was in Texas a little while before making Ace Ventura when they took calls in San Antonio, so don't mess with Texas, that's what I've heard, and we're certainly not doing it today. We've had some great times, we've had some great panels here, and meeting lots of the fans who have come to WhoFest before, and it's been a great time.
Thank you very much for being here. It's been fantastic getting to see you and meet you and talk with you, and hope to see you again someday.
Certainly, and I just got one thing to say to you, KBO Lane, KBO.
All right. WhoFest 3 is the last day, and I've had the honor and privilege of meeting Simon Fisher-Becker from Doctor Who, and it's been fantastic getting to see you and talk to you again. And Simon, how have you been enjoying the convention so far?
All conventions are wonderful, but this one, I have to say, has been a very special weekend. It's been the best weekend I've had in a long, long time. And why weren't you here? You've missed all the fun. The fans have been delightful and have been here solely to have fun. So come along to next year at the WhoFest 4 and enjoy the fun. And I look forward to seeing you there, hopefully. But until then, Doctor Who!
Awesome. Thank you very much. WhoFest 3 has been awesome, and I've been able to meet Richard Franklin, who played Captain Yates on the Doctor Who during the Pertwee era, and it's been absolutely fantastic. So, how do you like the convention so far?
The convention has been absolutely marvelous. What a pity you weren't here! Why weren't you here?
It was great, actually. I've never been to Dallas before, and I've had a really lovely warm welcome from everybody, including the cameraman who can't see.
So Richard, would you fancy a pint?
No thanks. I'd rather have a dance. We'll be right back.
WhoFest 3 is over. Had a great time. It was awesome. And, man, I just hate that it's over because I don't want to go.
Excuse me, sir. We really need you to leave now.
Okay.